Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to the celebration of life for Twilight Stout. When I think of Twilight Stout, I think of wonderful memories. And these memories were truly fantastic, and they go all the way back to the time I was elected district governor. Back then, they were called district governors, now they're division directors. And when I was in Ventura getting elected, I had some words of encouragement from a lovely lady with a wonderful smile. And that wonderful smile came from none other than Twyla Stout. When I think of Twyla Stout, I think of encourager, supporter, a person who loves Toastmasters, loves life, loves many things. And when I go over to the Central Valley community of the Toastmasters of Modesto, Merced, and Fresno, and anywhere else in the Central Valley, I think of Twyla, because I know that one of those events, whether it be a contest, whether it be a conference, I can surely guarantee that one great smile will come from Twyla Stout. Now, before we get to the moments of remembrance, rejoice, and reminders, we do have a video to share. And would you please cue the video? Was a beautiful tribute to a beautiful woman, Twyla Stout. And whenever we think of Twyla Stout, who could not have more of a smile other than Twyla Stout? Not only a smile in the face, but also a smile in the heart. Up next, we have a poem for Twyla that will be given by Mr. Gerardo R.D. Gerardo?
Thank you, Jesse. It's 5 o'clock in the morning here in the Middle East. And as you can see, I can't help my tears because every time I remember Twyla, I also remember my mom and my grandma. So Twyla, this is for you. In memory of Twyla Stout, a soul so dear, whose presence filled our hearts with cheer. A great person, a friend beyond compare. Her absence now leaves a void hard to bear. She touched our lives in countless ways, brightening our darkest and gloomiest days. a beacon of light, an inspiration true, a mentor guiding us as we grew. Her words, like gems, forever remain in our hearts and minds they sustain. The wisdom she shared, the lessons taught, will forever stay, never to be forgot. In distinguished Toastmasters, she excelled. Her passion for speaking, stories she would tell. With eloquence and grace, she took center stage, leaving us inspired in a speech-filled rage. As a friend, Twyla brought warmth and delight, a listening ear, a comforting sight. She understood us through joys and strife. In her presence, we found solace in life. Though we mourn her loss, our hearts ache. She lives on in memories we will not forsake. For as long as we live, her spirit remains. In our laughter, tears, and joyful refrains. Twyla Stout, forever cherished, forever adored. In our hearts, your presence is still restored. We honor your legacy, your light forever will forever shine. A friend, a mentor, and an inspiration divine. Though your physical presence may be gone, your love and guidance will forever live on. Fondly remembered, our hearts will never part. Twyla Stout, forever etched in our hearts. We love you, Twyla.
Beautiful. That was beautiful. Wow. Up next, we have a special prayer for Twyla Stout. And to give this prayer, please help me welcome Pastor National President, Senior Toastmaster, Accredited Speaker, Dilip Abasekera. Dilip?
Thank you. Thank you, Jesse. And greetings to you, my fellow Toastmasters and friends, especially friends of Twyla Stout. As you know, we are gathered today to honor distinguished Toastmaster Twyla Stout, who passed away on November 27, 2023. Eliza Juliana, Twyla's goddaughter, is carrying out Twyla's wish that we gather as Toastmasters to celebrate her life on her birthday today, February 8th. Twyla was a Christian, active in her church. Knowing that I'm a retired pastor, Eliza asked me to give a prayer in tribute to Twyla. Will you, in your own way, please join me as I say this prayer? Dear Lord, even though we are in many different places and countries, we are gathered today as one body to honor the life of a great Toastmaster, DTM Twyla R. Stout. Lord, thank you for Twyla, who was a Toastmaster for more than 25 years and a member of more than 15 clubs. There are many in this gathering who are touched by Twyla's love of life and her passion for Toastmasters. We ask you to comfort those who are grieving Twyla's passing, especially her daughter Terry and her family, and her goddaughter Eliza. We celebrate Twyla's life, which elevated so many others in Toastmasters, in our church, in women's associations, and in her community. Eternal God, you have shared with us the life of Twyla Stout. Before she was ours, she is yours. For all that Twyla has given us to make us what we are, for that of her which lives and grows in each of us, and for her life, the life that in your love will never end, we give you thanks. And now we offer Twyla back into your arms. Comfort us in our loneliness. Strengthen us in our weakness, and give us courage to face the future unafraid. Draw those of us who remain in this life closer to one another. Make us faithful to serve one another, and lead us to know that peace and joy, which is eternal life. We pray all this in the name of the one who is our creator, sustainer, and redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Dilip. Up next, we will discuss our moments of remembrance, rejoice, and reminder. And next person I will call will be the district director for District 33. Please help me welcome distinguished Toastmaster Tan Pham. Tan?
Good evening, Toastmasters, friends, and family. Thank you for joining tonight's celebration of life for District 33 Area F1 Director, distinguished Toastmaster Toast Twyla Stout. We are thankful for all she did for our members and clubs across the entire district. She will be remembered for her energy, her compassion, humor, and honesty as she touched so many lives. And we owe it to Twyla to carry on her legacy by being the best versions of ourselves and to live every moment to its fullest. Let's keep having fun and keep growing. So Twyla, we know you're watching us. Happy birthday. We love you. You will always have a place in our hearts. Thank you.
Thank you, District Director Tan. And up next, we have words of remembrance from the 1992 World Champion of Public Speaking, distinguished Toastmaster and accredited speaker, Mr. Dana Lamon. Dana?
Sorry for the delay. It takes me a moment to work with my device. And I apologize for not being on the screen to share with you, but I am still recovering from some health issues from last year. In these few moments, let me say, the 100 years of success of Toastmasters International is primarily due to the members supporting one another. Twyla Stout is the embodiment of that support. Twyla would support individuals who were seeking to improve their communication skills or to develop their presentation skills to move on to professional speaking. She supported the leaders of the district at all levels. She helped to resuscitate struggling clubs, and she supported the development of new clubs. Twyla supported me every time we had a chance to see each other face to face. It didn't matter whether I was the keynote speaker for the district and Twyla was there, I got support from her. I could be speaking at a virtual event. And recently I did one for the South County Toastmasters. Twyla presented the introduction. During the course of that presentation and after the event was over, in the chit chat afterwards, I shared with Twyla and those who were there my health issues from last summer. I was in a coma for 10 days. My heart stopped at one point. The doctors declared that I was dead. I didn't expect that that would come back, but on November 17, I received an email from Twyla. Twyla was sharing with me that she had to give an impromptu presentation at one of her Toastmasters clubs, and she wasn't sure on what to speak. And she turned and looked at her bookshelf, and she said there she saw my books and decided to give a presentation titled Book Report, in which she talked about a man who would not accept no, who would not quit. She went on to write in that November 17 email that she encouraged all Toastmasters that they should have Dana's books. And I'll tell you, Twyla was so supportive that not only did she have my four books, but whenever she had a chance, she would ask me if I had written yet another that she could buy. Well, after she did all of that praising, if you will, in that November 17 email, she says, and now that I've buttered you up, I have another request. I would like for you to speak at another event. I thought about that for a while as to whether I would be able to do that event. And so it was a week before I responded. I got her request on November 17. On November 24, I responded and I said, yes, I'll do it. Now, Twyla immediately responded on November 24, thank you. And then in her lighthearted way, as she would, intending no harm at all, she says, and by the way, don't go playing dead again and scaring us all. And then 3 days later, she left us. Twyla left us quite a legacy. And it would do well for us to remember that legacy. In Dilip's 1992 World Championship contest speech, he talked about love. And he said, love is giving. Love is enduring. Love is transforming. He was describing Twyla Stout. Giving, enduring, transforming. That's the love we have from her. And I will always cherish the legacy that she leaves us. Mr. Toastmaster.
Thank you very much, Dana. Wow. Up next, I will call upon for another friend of Twyla. Please help me welcome Sheila Sellers. Sheila. Sheila.
It's muted.
Hey, Sheila, you're on mute. Hmm. No, we can't hear you. Would you like to come back to you? We'll come back to you, Sheila. Up next, I'd like to call upon a fellow Toastmaster from the Central Valley. Please help me welcome distinguished Toastmaster Maria Acevedo. Maria.
Well, thank you, everyone. It's beautiful to see everyone here who shared such a wonderful part of Twyla's life. We all had a place, didn't we? And it was all thanks to her bringing us in some way. And she wasn't afraid to reach out. And I thought that was part of her special gift. She really was someone. And
sorry for the technical difficulties. What I was saying, she had a gift of seeing the good in people. And she wasn't afraid to point that out to you. I even received a last note from her where she was helping remind me of what a good person I was and what I can offer the world. And I just thought that was so special that she still continued to do that. And I remember meeting her years ago, and little did I know how much she would help me grow. And she did it by pushing and voluntelling. I know that was the first time I ever heard of that phrase, voluntold, and she was good at it. The way I thought she was good at it was because she was balanced that, oh, I'm kind of old aspect of who she was, and used that as a little bit of a way to get away with what she wanted to share with us and push us to do. But either way, she always had good intention. She brought fun to a meeting, and she did have a twinkle in her eye. It really helped us have fun and recognize the true meaning of being a kind human. And she was that. So it's wonderful to share my thoughts with you all today and be part of that legacy and continue on carrying on her characteristics with others.
Thank you, Maria. Up next, we have representative from Sunrise. Please help me welcome Robert Mansfield with a memory. Robert?
Thank you very much, Toastmaster. As president of the Sunrise Club, I wanted to thank Twyla Stout for her years of dedicated service. She was the first to greet you in the morning with a smile, calling our meetings to order with enthusiasm to clear our slumbering minds. Behind the scenes and behind all of this, she made Toastmasters look simple. She was a source of information for our club, bringing us news from our division, area, and internationally. There was nothing that she wouldn't do for us. She brought in humor and fun that was refreshing and inspiring. Mentorship and bringing up the next generation of Toastmasters has been a lifelong goal of hers. And speaking for our club, we thank you, Twyla, from the bottom of our hearts. Personally, Twyla was a source of understanding at a time when I was walking away from a 25-year injury and leaving a black and white world of medical nonsense. Twyla was able to help me see the many shades of gray that were all around me. In a give and take relationship, I would receive guidance in looking and listening, and she would receive understanding into the digital world. Over time, we discovered we lived a few thousand yards from each other as the crow flies. That Monday, Twyla called me in the mid-afternoon. "You should rely on the ones closest to you," she said. "So tag, you're it." Which I'm sick. I really need the Merced County Times and ginger ale. Would you be kind enough to bring these to me? And we thanked each other in her driveway She gave me a bag of yams, and we said we'd see each other again soon. And I close with this thought of Twyla. Twyla, they wrote your name in the sky, but the wind blew it away. They wrote your name in the sand, but the waves washed it away. We wrote your name in our hearts, and there it will stay. As we wave goodbye to a vessel that has sailed her course, others on the other side are waving hello and seeing a ship full sail in her prime coming home. We love you, Twyla. Thank you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Robert. Up next, a representative from Big Shots, we have Atalie Womble. Atalie?
Maybe you can relate to this. Someone invites you to an activity like dinner or a party. You say no. The same thing happens again another time or two. You're asked to do something and you decline. Pretty soon you notice that person doesn't bother inviting you to anything anymore. Depending on the person, maybe you'd be happy about that, but I know there are definitely times I've been disappointed or felt forgotten. Except when the person on the other end was Twyla. Twyla regularly sent me material she thought might apply or be of interest and invited me to public and private events. Even though my answer was constantly that I had to work or put my kids to bed or some other excuse, she didn't write me off as a lost cause. She continued to reach out. I first thought Twyla must have really valued relationships, and I'm sure she did, but what I was reflecting on in particular was a little different. Even in cases where there wasn't reciprocal action on the other end, she was steadfast. And in about everything she did, whether that be providing tailored feedback, giving inspirational speeches, joining lots of clubs, and being a social butterfly in general, this all demonstrated that she made herself a resource and a neighbor to even people she didn't have a relationship with at all yet. That's when I realized it was connection that she especially valued. Sure, she loved to have connection with people directly, but she was also happy to connect people to other people or with information and connect them to an experience or a growth opportunity. Regardless of whether she got any relationship benefits, she continued to engage others to find ways that connection could help benefit them. A much more selfless concept in the end, and an amazing legacy. I think she'd be elated if she saw how we have all connected our stories, skills, memories, and time to put this program together. And we also should be elated, because how fortunate are we to have had a model like her in our lives to inspire us to make connections too.
Thank you, Atalie. Up next, we have a representative from Linguistic Links. Please help me welcome, with her remembrance, Karen Mouse. Karen.
Thank you. 2 minutes to eulogize Twyla? Not possible. I need structure, so I picked alphabetical structure in remembrance of Twyla. She was attractive and articulate. She was bubbly and had bountiful energy. A caring Coke drinker. Yes, I know it's not the kind you drank, but it's still Coke. She was dedicated and dear to all. Energetic and encouraging. Friendly, fun-loving, and a flower fancier. She was generous, gregarious, hilarious, and a hat wearer. She was ingenious, impish, and a jocular joke master. She was kind to people and also kind to animals, loving and lovable. My magnificent mentor. Nearby when needed, outgoing and outlandish, perceptive and positive, queen of the table dance and the belly dance, so I'm told. She was rich with friends. She was sincere. She was a terrific Toastmaster and traveler. She was unstoppable in her uniqueness. She was a vivacious volunteer. She was willing to mentor others. She was xenial, which means hospitable to people from other countries. She was young at heart, and she was zealous for those she loved. Twyla, when it's my turn to pass over, I'm going to be looking for you right in the middle of the group of welcoming committee. I'm looking for your face even now. We love you. We'll see you again.
Thank you very much, Karen. And up next, before I go into Division F, I would like to introduce Sheila Sellers. Sheila, are you there?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, yes.
I was having some problems getting on. So I can speak for a couple minutes. Is that what's happening?
That is correct. And a timer is right there.
Thank you. I met Twyla about 25 years ago. I wanted to start a couple of clubs before I retired from teaching. And there was going to be a conference about a month after I had joined up in Modesto. So I went, and there were four of us ladies, and I slept with Twyla. And she sat and read. But I didn't know her well enough to say, Twyla, would you please stop reading and go to sleep? She was an avid reader. I went to her house. She was sometimes, she definitely was multitasked. One time I went to a conference with her to Las Vegas, and she sat up at the co-pilot seat of the van, talked the whole way, but I didn't mind at all because she had such wonderful stories. She was a dear, dear friend. And one of my favorite stories that she told, and I wanted her to retell it someday, when she was getting a divorce, she had a pink Cadillac from working and selling Mary Kay Cosmetics. And her almost husband, or whatever, she was getting a divorce from him, he was going to give it to his girlfriend. She took the Cadillac, went through one of those metal fences, drove it into a swimming pool. It's like, if I can't have the Cadillac, she can't have the Cadillac. I love her dearly, and she was a wonderful friend. And someday I hope to see her upstairs.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sheila. Up next, we do have a representative from Division F. Please help me welcome Distinguished Toastmaster, Mr. Chris Hempelman. Chris?
Thank you very much, Mr. Toastmaster. Twyla, fellow Toastmasters of Division F, District 33 and beyond, I wanted to say thank you for all of the great motivational, helpful speeches, moral support, time, leadership over the past 14 years. My time in Toastmasters, your speeches gave me the courage to step up, lead in this organization and in the community. You were there for all of us, for the many club, area, division, district-wide programs, trainings, and for the countless hours of the pre-planning for these events. And one of your hallmark speeches, quote, the power of someday, end of quote, given at Supper Club 5353 in 2020, you told us how someday you will pursue new challenges such as the Pathways Educational Program. You did by giving us dynamic, creative, and insightful speeches. By the fellow Toastmasters, great speeches, leadership, time, talent, and a great life. Until we meet again someday. Mr. Toastmaster.
Thank you very much, Chris. Up next, we have a representative from Supper Club 5353. Please help me welcome Lottie Askew. Lottie?
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Supper Club, I'm truly honored to share this tribute to our friend and mentor, Twyla Stout. By the way, I never heard the Pink Cadillac story before. I thought I'd heard all of them. Twyla would have really wanted us to celebrate this occasion with a little bit of wine or maybe some Coke. So in our honor. And I especially also want to recognize Twyla's daughter, Terry. Twyla was mom, so that's a little bit more than being a Toastmaster. We consider Twyla our very own at Supper Club, not because she lived in the area, but because her personality was truly a part of who Supper Club was. On Monday nights, she was always the first to log in and the last to leave. She was always fully present with that infectious smile and personality that made us feel like we alone, Supper Club, was special. But tonight, as you can see, Twyla gave her all to so many people and all over the world. As my mentor, Twyla often emailed me about interesting people I should meet and opportunities to grow. As she often said, I never invite anyone to a meeting. I invite people to learn something new or to a new opportunity. Hey, Eliza, pay attention to this one. The last email she sent to me was this. Hey, you've got to meet Eliza, the fireball from South County and a public relations genius. She's upside down in time from us. Twyla had friends all over the world. Well, I spoke at the club meeting about ideas for improving membership. Like I mentioned, she was always the last to leave, but this time she had a distant expression and said, I have to go. I think you guys have got this. And I think we got this. May Twyla's legacy live within all of us. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Lottie. Up next, we have a representative from South County Presenters. Please help me welcome, with his remembrance, Joel Chawla. Joel?
Toastmaster of the day, fellow members, and all who remember Twyla Stout. She was a very important person that connected me to my passion, my love with Toastmasters. This was in a different dimension. I was always in the face-to-face world pre-COVID, but I came into Twyla through social media and through the Zoom world. It allowed me to grow in a different dimension. I was able to connect to her through technology. It amazed me that how much she cared for the membership. Her passion for Toastmasters was huge. She was a genius. She took her love, her passion that she had from interacting either in the library or in the school to a different level by using Toastmasters to continue that joy. That joy will continue even though she's not with us, because she's kept the legacy of how great having friendships with other people who want to grow, who want to become their next generation, to go above and beyond, to help others. Her love for Toastmasters is vast. She was involved in District 33 in all aspects. And then she explored the world, and especially Southeast Asia. She was able to do that because she made some pillar friendships through Zoom. She had different ideas. She went out of the box, and she encouraged everybody to stay outside of where their comfort level was, to grow, to push themselves to the next level, to become better. And she's a prime example that has helped me and helped many in this room grow to this next level. I look forward to seeing you, Twyla, not too far from now in the future, up in the heavens. Back to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you very much, Joel. Up next, we have a representative from Menu Masters with her remembrance. Please help me welcome Distinguished Toastmaster, immediate past District Director, Debbie Allman. Debbie?
Yes. Oh my gosh, these stories are so great. We should write them down because I've not heard all of these, but I want to tell you a couple that I've heard. And in the background, I'm telling you.
Debbie, we can't hear you.
Why can't you hear me? Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, it's because I had my finger over the... Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, there you go. So this is a birthday cake I bought, Twyla, and I bought my favorite flavor. I didn't know what hers was. I'm going to have that. I'm making dinner. I'm having a glass of wine, which is what Laddie said. She would always bring her best glassware. We had a Menu Masters is a foodie group. And this foodie group, I remember the first meeting of the year, she had this title. And imagine she's 80 years old, and this is her title. It was The Shortcut to Love. So she was talking about how to be kind of frugal with your resources. And she says, this is in the newsletter that we wrote up, nothing short of, Twyla didn't see the need of wasting a lot of time preparing fancy dinners before starting a romantic evening. This is an 80-year-old. This is so cool. So she showed us how to just be quick and do things easy. She had a Bake Alaska that she had as a presentation. All of her presentations started with a doily. That's the kind of classy person I'm going to go over. She also, her appearance, no matter what meeting she went to, she would always have jewelry on. She would have her Sunday clothes on. She would have her hair done, her eye makeup. It was a beautiful set. The last story I have is belly dancing. Somebody alluded to it, and that was Karen. She came into the meeting early, and she says, Debbie, I was in Bahrain. I said, oh, that's good. Well, I was in Bahrain, and they had a belly dancing contest, and I won it. So again, that is our 80-year-old Twyla Stout. Gone but not forgotten. She's lived a life worth celebrating. Back to you.
Thank you very much, Debbie. Fantastic memories. And I still have that pink Cadillac stuck in my head. Up next, we have a person from Membership Masters. Please, with his memories, please help me welcome Greg Morrow. Greg.
Thank you very much, Jesse, for that introduction. I only got some, even though I live fairly close to where Twyla lived, I live in Clovis. I really got to know her online, like many people got to know her online through Membership Masters, which is based in Bakersfield. Funny thing. But that's just kind of the trend, is that Twyla was able to reach out to people near and far. The thing that really stood out to me about her is her passion and zest for life. My parents are right around her age in the mid-80s. And for those of us that are entering or in middle age, we all know that there are times that we just don't feel like doing something. You know, the aches ache a little bit more, we're a little bit tired, more tired. It takes a little bit longer to recover than it did in our 20s and 30s. And as someone who is squarely in that middle age group now, AARP group, just eligible this year, to see somebody at Twyla's age with such a zest for life and excitement and energy. And she was this tiny little thing. I only saw her in person once, but I don't know how much over 5 feet tall she was. But boy, oh boy, did that woman know how to motivate people, how to inspire people, how to love on people, and how to bring people from different backgrounds together. And it reminds me, and it serves as a reminder, I think, to all of us, that getting old doesn't mean you have to act old. There is no acting your age, that you could be 80 years old, 85 years old, and wear hats and make speeches about love and romance, or ride pink Cadillacs into pools. So, Twyla, we miss you, and I look forward to seeing you on the other side.
Thank you very much, Greg. Up next, we have a memory from Maura from Battle Speakers United Kingdom. Please help me welcome Maura Ni Korone. Maura?
It's a privilege for me to say a few words on behalf of Battle Speaker Club about our dear friend, Twyla Stout. Born in 1938, she just died before Christmas. She was a woman of fashion. She dressed well, used accessories, and paid special attention in hats. She set a high standard in elegance. She was also passionate about cooking, especially quick, easy, and exciting food, which she loved to share. Sadly, she couldn't taste it on Zoom. Twyla and I both love pet animals. She liked to look after puppies, and she had three big dogs, two boxers and one Rhodesian Ridgeback. I have two cats and tropical fish. Twyla's goal in life was to find happiness in everything she did and support those around her. I share that beautiful thought with her. Yes, she was kind, compassionate, cheerleader, and she was full of energy, vitality, and enthusiasm, and gave sound advice to fellow members. She joined Toastmasters some 30 years ago in California, where she lived, and she was a DTM. She was a remarkable, wonderful woman, and we became close friends in Toastmasters, bridging the Atlantic Ocean. She raised funds for charity and worked hard to empower women. She kindly volunteered and gave us a speech on our special International Women's Day celebration in my other club last year. She loved and enjoyed that event. She was due to give a further speech in one of her clubs when she died. She just never gave up. And Dr. Smedley, who had been very proud of Twyla as an inspiring and shining example of Toastmasters. And I am sure that she is with him in heaven today.
Fantastic, Maura. Thank you very much. And up next, we have with us from World Travelers in Singapore, please help me welcome Kathy To. Kathy.
Thank you very much. Dear friends, families, and Those who love Twyla. Well, from what Twyla's viewer has fond memories of Twyla. We had fun, this is an online club, but her presence shows us that age, distance, and life setbacks doesn't deter us from having fun in Toastmasters and meeting friends. I remember we had Monopoly over Zoom over Christmas, and it was a challenge, but we had fun because the presence of families and friends is what makes the whole experience enjoyable. It may seem dull to just play on our own in front of the screen, but hearing the laughter, seeing the bright smile that's shown across the screen, that warms the heart of everyone. Twyla showed us that we are never too old to pursue love. We are never too old to enjoy life. Have a quote. Get that love of life. If you miss that one, find another one because there's always someone there for you. We miss you, Twyla. I do update. Back to you, Toastmasters Day.
Thank you very much, Kathy. Up next, we have a representative from Horizon, Al-Khobar in Saudi Arabia. Please help me welcome Mohammed Hassan. Mohammed?
Thank you, Jesse. Dear fellow Toastmasters, good day. I am not surprised to see in this meeting that distinguished Toastmaster Twyla has touched so many lives present here and many others. I am inspired all over again. This news came as a shock to me, as I felt there were so many wonderful years left in her. I had this plan that whenever I visit US, she was one of the two people I wanted to meet and spend some time with. To my utter shock, she departed this world before even that could happen. When someone you love becomes a memory, the memory becomes a treasure. She was an amazing and pure soul, soft-spoken, empathetic, supportive, and a dedicated person towards the betterment of individuals. She has offered me and several other members of our club several times to help with their speeches for contests. I have always found her inputs valuable and implementable. She has left a huge mark on us. She had transcended into our souls from the realms of the virtual world. She just felt like family. I've seen her support Eliza during her difficult times to the point that she was her second mother, yet they never met in person. This says a lot about a person. She has always supported us through thick and thin. I wish her soul rest in eternal peace. Although we couldn't meet in this world, but looking forward to see her in the world hereafter. Dear DDM Twyla, your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure, you're loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. Back to you, Jesse.
Thank you, Mohammed. Up next, representing Perla Silangan, Al-Khobar, please help me welcome Ed Sakurat. Ed?
Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction. I met Twyla because of Eliza, and it was during pandemic time. It was 3 years back. Twyla is a good friend of mine who always have time to teach someone who's asking help. Don't you know that the day she died, she still commented on my Facebook because she always say positive thing to everybody. She always told me that my dress is okay, the way I dress, because I traveled a lot, and she's the first people who will comment on my Facebook that my outfit is very nice and I did it well. That's how Twyla, it touched my heart. And I think that's for everybody. That's why she was born in February, because she meant to love everybody. Twyla, you gone first, but we will all go there. And I know that we will meet in her life hereafter someday. You will live in our heart forever. And that's why I didn't make any draft of my speech, because I want something that is coming from my heart. And 2 minutes is not enough for Twyla to tell something about Twyla. Twyla, we love you so much. Wherever you are now, you will live forever in our heart. And we miss you a lot. I consider you as a sister, mother, a father sometimes. You touch our hearts, and you will live forever in our hearts. Goodbye, Twyla. And I believe goodbye in the dictionary doesn't mean forever. We will see you there up in heaven. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Ed. Each of us has our own stories, our own memories of Twyla to share. And as you heard a plethora of people give their memories, remembrance, and reminders, as well as a chance to rejoice that wonderful woman. Legacy is amazing. And you know, a legacy can be truly amazing when you have touched lives of fellow Toastmasters, fellow people from all over the world. That, my friends, is the power of Twyla. We have 56 people on this special occasion. And may these 56 people carry Twyla in all of us. Up next, we'll have a tribute to Twyla. It is a familiar song, Don't Worry, Don't Be Happy, by Ruth Levisky. Ruth?
Thank you, Jesse.
Thank you very much for that wonderful Don't Worry, Be Happy. And it's a reminder, don't worry, be happy. In life, we may have trouble. When we worry, we make it double. So it's always best to don't worry and be happy. Twyla would love that if we carry that along within her legacy. Up next, we have some final words from Twyla's daughter. And please help me welcome Twyla's daughter, Terry Beckman. Terry?
Hi, can you hear me?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
And you can see me?
Yes.
This has been wonderful. And I know you all loved my mom and she loved all of you. And my mother had this thing about the letter T, because that's what her name started with. So she named everything with a T. My dogs were like Tuffy, Trumpet, Turgon. Everything was a T. And so then she had me and named me Terry, and she named my brother Tim. I didn't know that 25 years ago, she was going to have another child. And she named that child Toastmaster. And that became like a sibling to me, because that's all she talked about. And sometimes we wondered, does she love Toastmasters more than she loves us? But she loved everyone. She loved to talk. She loved the dogs that she babysat, and the cats, and the birds, and the fish. She loved people And like the one gal said, she loved to read. And she liked to, her favorite thing was to come here to Iowa and go to our little thrift store and buy Christmas presents for all her friends. And she just knew, you know, what everybody liked. And I would always say, Mom, don't do that, you know? But she would do it. So it's because she wanted to know everybody and everything about them. And I think that y'all know, have caught the essence of her. She had a wonderful wit. She never got up a day in her life where she wasn't happy to be alive. And I think that she just finally got tired. And she just, her unity, the unity thought for the day on the day that she died was, Lord, I'm tired. I'm just going to let go and let God. And she went to sleep and woke up in heaven. And I know that she's probably up there organizing groups. So you guys will probably have to stand in line to join groups with her. So thank you very much, everybody. All the words were so kind. And the flute lady was wonderful. And thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much, Terry. And to wrap this up, this wonderful memory of Twyla Stout, I would be remiss if I didn't thank the person that brought all this together, that had the heart, the passion, and the dedication. Eliza, your passion is shown for Twyla, and is shown through the greatest of heart, and you have heart and desire to actually put this together, just remembrance of Twyla. So from the people that are here, inside and outside of Toastmasters, I have two words. Thank you, thank you. And one thing I will say, if you have someone that you love and you appreciate, always take this time to let the person know how much you love them. Because if you have that love right there, it would have that good feeling and good heart. Now, with that being said, I thank all of you for coming to this special remembrance celebration of life for Twyla. And let's live the best way we know how, especially in honor of Twyla. Thank you very much, everybody.
Say you hear better. But then again, throughout the meeting and all the speakers, we keep a topic
of how much time we use unnecessary sounds and brush words. Share with us.
Thank you very much, Loco. I agree with Landa. Having blindfolded and trying to listen, until you hear better.
How would that question? Twyla.
For this holiday, I would thank the farmer's wife. Because she helped me eat a turkey, paint all my feathers white. So the farmer thinks I'm a chicken. So I went around the farmyard going cluck, 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 instead of gobble, gobble, gobble. And the farmer's wife is the one who found the white paint to paint me white. So I have a great debt of gratitude for the farmer's wife. And she served him squash casserole for dinner on Thanksgiving instead of bird. So sometimes when you're sitting at the table, look at the things on that table, and who do you have to thank for them? The little kid that picked all the broccoli or all the Brussels sprouts, or maybe the lady who made the sweet potato pie. Chief and I have already talked about sweet potato pie instead of pumpkin pie. But I'm almost entirely
vegetables and fruit down. And my father was a turkey man. I had to chase a lot of turkeys when I was a kid to catch them for Thanksgiving dinner. So I understand why a turkey would paint his feathers white so the farmer would think he was a chicken and not a turkey. Back to you, Vanessa.
Thank you, Twyla. I love that. Let's all...
Charlotte.
Go, Artie.
Go, Artie.
Go, Twyla, Twyla, Twyla.
Okay, and
go, Twyla, go, Artie.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now at match number four. We have, shall Toastmasters adopt price discrimination offer to membership fees to students? Twyla.
Pricing for Toastmasters. I think they should not only have a price for students, but they should have a price for people who belong to more than one club. Since I belong to 15 clubs, you can imagine how much my tuition will be just for 6 months. So I definitely think that Toastmasters should switch to a variation in fees for Toastmasters as students or with multiple clubs. Reminds me of a date I had who was very, very cheap. This guy called me and asked me for a date. I was about Eliza's age, young and sweet and single, and he asked me out to go to the movies with him. And I said, well, what movie? And he said it was Tom Cruise. Well, I love Tom Cruise and Top Gun, so I agreed to go out with him. But he was so cheap that he showed up at my door walking and expected me to walk to the movies with him, which I did. So then he went up to buy the ticket. He bought one ticket in the cheap seats. So I had to go up and buy my own ticket. That was really cheap. I wanted to poke the man. So we go in and he goes to the candy counter. He buys one small Coke and one small box of Jujube. I thought, what a cheap man.
A speech called Five Chapters of Twyla's Life. And when I got through with the five chapters, they wanted a continued story. So the next week I did chapters 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the men in Twyla's life. So that was kind of fun to sort of tell my story of things that had happened to me. And I didn't start Toastmasters until I was after 50 years of age. So I'm not,
you should be leading us in those. And so I was a club president. And I sort of happily went along in the club leadership role. And I've taken all offices in the club. And then someone says, well, follow someone. She needs a shadow. And I followed the area director. And I went to all of her meetings and went to some meetings for her. And then the next year, I was the area director. And so I followed as area director along with the division director. And I accompanied her along. And the next thing I knew, I was the division director. And no, I never made district director. I stayed down below that. But I served area director twice, division director once, and then I went through the district secretary. And then I became a conference chair and a contest chair and a chief judge. So I have served at the district level up until about last year. And then I got out of all the first speech I heard in that club was a woman who called the speech, the first man I killed. And I'm going, whoa, what am I doing in here? But I was really rewarded when one of the young women came rushing up to me and threw her arms around me at a meeting and said, oh, Twyla, I want to thank you so much. She says, I had a probation hearing. And she says, and maybe in 3 years I have another probation and I can be released and get out. And she was in her 30s and she'd been in prison since she was 19. Because she was in a gang group that they had killed a gas station attendant. And she was just a remarkable woman, very a young Christian woman. She'd found her way to speaking better, to learning better, and her probation hearing was very fluid. They were proud of her for joining the organizations and for getting her education. So that was a rewarding point in my life, was seeing that I had helped some young women see a future with hope. When I tuned in from my hospital bed to join the meeting, and they're going, Twyla, you're here from the hospital, but just a little thing like a little surgery wasn't going to keep me from attending the meeting. So
You got me without makeup and everything, laying on my white pillow looking like death warmed over me and my fellow Toastmasters, because we have something for you. We have something for everyone. There is a benefit in joining Toastmasters, and we will show you what it is. So
here we go. Get me out of full screen so I can give her her 30 seconds. And here we go. Hoop and holler as she...
Belly dancing.
So impressed by this club. Every time I come, I find something new to go back and tell my other clubs, you should see what they're doing over there. You should see what that club does. You should take this idea and try it out. So I'm going, aha, 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 aha. I'm writing like crazy on my little notebook pad because you are so far ahead of so many with your technology uses in this club and your professional speeches. You are absolutely champions because you are a model club. A world famous model club. You are stupendous, as the young man says. So congratulations on another meeting. Well, well, well done.
Thank you, Twyla. We'll never forget you. Until next time, take care.
Great job, you guys. Wow, that was amazing.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Eliza.
Thank you.
Shall we sing happy birthday to her? Anybody want to sing happy birthday?
Good job, Jesse.
Yeah. Thank you, Eliza.
Thank you, Jesse. Thank you, Dilip. Thank you, everyone.
Wow.
Thank you, Eliza. That touching tribute, fantastic tribute.
This could be a business. You did a really professional job. That was amazing.
Thank you, Deepak, for spending your time with us.
Oh, Deepak, he's my favorite.
So,
a great evening.
Good night, you guys. Great job.
Take care.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.
See you next Monday, Eliza.
Happy birthday.
I'm busy with my presidential election, so I'm not busy in February. Pray for new president.
You're worth waiting for.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you, everyone.
Bye-bye.
God bless everyone. Eliza.
Thank you.
We love you.